Hi friends, welcome back to Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Today I'll show you how to make beef roast. Roast meat is an all-time favorite at home. This is a super moist, perfectly seasoned, tender roast beef recipe. Roast meat can be enjoyed with cooked potatoes, french fries, along with a salad or as a sandwich. Try to cook the perfect roast beef for a Sunday lunch or a dinner party. Roasting is one of the easiest way, whether it's beef, pork or lamb. Season the meat ahead of time, like the night before you plan to roast, so that the flavorings have enough time to penetrate the meat. Roast beef might sound fancy and complicated to make, but it is actually quite simple. With a good piece of meat and some simple herbs, you can have a roast beef that's way more tender and flavorful than the store-bought kind. Roasting is one of the simplest way to cook a large piece of meat. It yields a tender interior and browned exterior. Roast beef, roast potato are one of the favorite combinations. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. If you like this recipe of mine, do give a thumbs up and click the like button. So let's check out the ingredients. Here I have taken 2-inch piece of ginger, slightly crushed, 6 to 7 green chilies, 10 garlic pods, and a small bunch of coriander leaves with the stalk. Grind this to a fine paste. This is 1 kg of beef, boneless. Cut it into big chunks. Drain it, wash it and drain it. This is 2-inch piece of ginger which I have just crushed it, and this is the ground masala. This is the green masala. Add the ginger, the green masala to the meat pieces. Add salt as per taste. Here I have added ginger twice. One is the crushed one and the other is ground with the masala. 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder and juice of 1 lemon. Mix everything well and let it sit for a couple of hours. I usually marinate and let it sit overnight and cook it the next day afternoon. Mix it very well. See that all the pieces are coated with the masala. Don't add any water, it will leave its own juices. Once you remove it from the fridge, if you are marinating it overnight, please do keep it refrigerated. Give it a nice good mix. Here I have taken whole spices, 3 pods of cardamom, few elaichis, around 20 peppercorns, 2-inch piece of cinnamon stick. This is around 8 cloves of around 3 red chilies. Chilies are optional, but I like to add it. You can add a bay leaf if you like. Add around 3 teaspoons of oil and add the whole spices and let it crackle well. Once the masalas crackle, add the marinated beef to it. Saute it for a few minutes, around 2 to 3 minutes, till the masala pieces are coated with the oil. See that the flame is on sim. You need not brown the pieces, but just saute it for a few minutes. This brings out a good flavor. Add around 2 to 3 teaspoons of water, not more, because the meat will release its own juices and cook. Now I cook the meat till it is 75 to 80% done. You can cook it in a pressure cooker or you can cook it on an open pot. But if you are cooking it on an open pot, see that you keep a plate of water and keep the flame on sim. Open the lid and there you will find water in the pot. Now let the water get dried up. I like to add a carrot to it. This is optional, but I like the taste of carrot in this. You can add potatoes also. I usually fry the potatoes and serve it along with it. Don't dry it completely. At this point of time, you will see the meat gets drier and oil starts separating out of it. I try to switch off the flame at this time because as you try to cook it or reheat it, it becomes drier and drier. So at this point of time, switch off the flame. Serve it with fried potatoes, a salad, or I like to sometimes serve it with plain dal and rice. If you like this recipe of mine, do give it a try. I'm sure you all will enjoy it. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and do not forget to click the bell icon to get notified as and when I upload a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box below. So my sweet friends, hope you enjoyed this quick and yummy recipe. Stay tuned for more such interesting recipes. Till we meet again, check out my other recipes at Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Bye, see you soon with a new interesting recipe.